Love is not just a word. And to have Allah loving you, this is not going to happen before you love Allah and you fulfill what He ordered you to do. You have seen the order of the hadith. When I know some people that believe in some holy people and follow them blindly, and those people do not even pray. Wallahi, they do not even pray. I say, how could you follow somebody and treat him as a wali and he doesn't even pray? They say, I don't understand, because this guy is so close to Allah that he doesn't have to pray anymore. Wow! Closer than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was lying down on his deathbed and he says, As-salah, as-salah, and he drags his feet and he joins the jama'ah while he's dying. You mean that your leader is even nearer to Allah than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? The Prophet had to pray until the last moment in his life because he was not near enough. And your holy man, exempt from the prayer. You know Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, have you heard of him? A great righteous person, may Allah have mercy on him, said once he saw physically, not in a dream, something that blocked the horizon, a huge throne between the heavens and the earth, blocked the scene, blocked the sunlight. And someone who's sitting on the throne and said, Ya Abdul Qadir, I'm Allah, I'm your Lord. You know, it is breathtaking, it is shocking. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw Jibreel in this condition, he fell unconscious. He said, Ya Abdul Qadir, I'm your Lord. I love you so much, I exempt you from the prayer. You don't have to pray anymore. He recognized this is nothing but the shaitan. He said, Ikhsa ya adu Allah, I know you. You Satan. Why? Because how could Allah ordain the prayer on His Prophet and exempt me from it? Use your mind. Righteousness and walaya is not a certificate to be sold. We heard about Rabi'ah and the Prophet ﷺ could not give him a promise, could not tell him, okay, just take this letter and inshallah meet me at the gate of heaven, I'm going to take you with me. Now he said, help me out, achieve much of sujood in order to be eligible. So Allah the Almighty says in ayah number 31 of Surah Al Imran, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهَ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبْكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَاللَّهُ غَفُورٌ رَّحِيمٌ. Say, O Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. Why don't you say صلى الله عليه وسلم? Muhammad, louder. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If you love him, every time you hear his name, you should send the peace and the blessings upon him. Sometimes you say out loud to remind those who are sitting next to you, right and left, because we're negligent and we forget a lot. So Allah the Almighty says, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to your followers, if you truly love Allah, then follow me. If you do, Allah will love you and will forgive you your sins. This is the real test. Following the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam strictly and his guidance means that you truly love Allah and you truly love the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam.